Thank you so much for joining me once again. In this tutorial, we'll look at the Word document or the document version of WPS. How do we work it? Okay. How do we do some very basic editing in the Word document? But for now, we'll look at the general overview of the Word document platform. So you can come to new, and like I've explained in the previous video, you can start your document from templates, like we have shown earlier, or you can start from a blank sheet, which we are going to start at this moment. So you can click on blank sheet and it's going to open a blank piece of paper, just like so, just like the normal piece of paper. You can see this is the A4 type of paper. You can see everything. And just like the way if you have used Microsoft Word before, it's kind of similar to the Microsoft Word arrangement in that you have the paper arranged in A4 size, and you have the home tab where you have the copy and paste option. You can do different kind of copying and pasting. You can copy things from different places and come and paste them in this document. You can do format painter. I will show you how to do format painting, and you can do a lot of text editing. Okay, you can do change the font style, the font sizes, and different kind of sizes. You can increase or decrease sizing from here, and you can increase, you can do with all these other text editing, basic text editing features, like change the color, change the background color, and do some suffix and prefix to your document. You can bold, italize, and underline. You can do all that from here, and different kind of alignment and different kind of arrangement of the text. Okay, you can do different kind of styles from here. You can create your own new styles, or you can come to Microsoft or Word type setting. Okay, you can do different kind of Word type setting, or you can do find and replace, or you can change the selector, or you can change the very basic settings from here. So just like you have in Microsoft Word, you can come over to the insert features. You can insert different kind of things, from page break to blank page to tables to pictures to shapes, different kind of shapes, pictures. You can insert pictures from your computer or from a PDF document, or picture to document. You can do all that. You can insert directly from external sources. You can add comments in cases when you want to work collaboratively with others, or you can check the charts or Word art if you are interested. And you can check, make envelopes, and you can create header and put and footer, page numbers, watermarks. You can do all that from here with just simple click. So I will show you in detail how to use all of this feature. And then you have the page layout, where you can change the orientation of the pages from portrait to landscape, or change the margin. Okay, you have the option to change the margin to any kind of size you are interested in, or you can change the effects, or you can change the columns to one column or two columns. And you can have other preferences as well, different kind of preference. You can create table of content from here, different style of table of content. I will show you in detail how to create all this, and footnote, endnote, insert footnote. You can do all that. We'll go into detail about how to use this. And then mailing options, you can insert an open data source, insert different kind of fields, and you can email things or document as you're working on them from here. And then we have review features in cases when you want to edit your student's document, or you want to review a data. You can be able to insert comments, be it type written comment or handwritten comment. You can do that. You can do text to speech, or you can do check word count, or check spell check there about, or you can accept or review changes that someone has made in a previous document that you're working on. We're going to look in detail about how to use all that. Then you have the view options. You can change the view to outline view, to web view, to navigation pane. You can play around with the ruler option. You can enable all that from here. And table grid lines, you can enable that. Zoom in and zoom out. You can go to page width and multiple pages, single page. You can change the view from here. And sections, you can add different kind of sections, table of contents, margins. You can change orientations as well as page numbers and header and footer. We've explained some of these in the previous class. And you have special features, okay, where you can convert from PDF to Word, to PDF to Excel, to PowerPoint. You can export documents in PDF, or you can export them in picture or thereabout. So it's very easy to kind of make use of all these features if you have tried to use the Microsoft Word before. If you have used Microsoft Word before, it's kind of very easy to have access to and use this Word document. So over here you have the other options like the zooming options. You can zoom in and out, and you can scale to fit. If you want everything to be full screen, you can click on this and you'll be able to have it full screen. You can change the percentage, you can increase. Right now it is at 150. You can reduce or increase the zoom level. You can do all sort of alignments there about. We'll go in detail. I will show you how to do use most of these features. And at the bottom left over here, you have the word count, spell check. You can have character count. You'll be able to see everything, all the details of what you're working on over here. So this is a bit about the general overview of the Word document platform. Okay, in the next class we are going to look at how to bring in text, how to type in text, how to copy and paste text from other platforms, and do some very basic text editing in this very platform. So until next class, thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next class.